In this video, we are going to study about bucket elevator for material handling. Bucket elevator. So what is mean by bucket? So bucket is usually an open top container, so that the bucket we use regularly that has open top container, its top is open. In similar way, in bucket elevator we use a series of buckets which have its top open for the purpose of elevating the material from downside to upside. That means in vertically movement of material we use bucket elevator. So let's see bucket elevator. Bucket elevators are powered equipment used for conveying bulk material in vertical or steep incline path, consisting of endless belt or chain to which metallic buckets are fixed. So it is a power equipment. Movement is made in vertical direction or sometimes in incline direction, and for this purpose we use the endless end. So with flexible belt the buckets move unidirectionally, so that can move only in one direction, that cannot reverse its direction. And it is collected, the material is, you can look in this figure, the material is collected here by the buckets. So the material to be given here, and they are collected by these moving buckets here. The vertical lift may be from few meters to more than 50 meters. So what could be the height of material movement? That may be from few meter to more than 50 meter. And if we look at the capacity may vary from 2 to 4 ton per hour. So in 1 ton per hour, so that depends upon the requirement of the plant. So you can look in this image, this is a image of one processing plant in which this is the belt conveyor. So belt conveyor is used for horizontal movement of the material, and this is the bucket elevator which is used for vertical movement of the material. So here is a wheat grain, that grain comes from this belt conveyor here, and that is being here. For maintenance purpose, an inspection window is provided at the boot section of the bucket elevator. Sometimes it is an enclosed portion, and here is some inspection window is provided. So like this is the closed, but sometime here is some window like area is provided, so that from this window we can observe the movement of these buckets. Or the main function of elevator. Now you can look here, the bucket elevator is being used in one of the silo unit or factory where the wheat material is being conveyed to bucket elevator. So look, its height is very high. So vertical movement of the wheat material in a
spacing and mode of discharge of material. So there are five types of bucket elevator. Number one, centrifugal discharge elevator. Number two, positive discharge elevator. Number three, so you can look in this image, this is the centrifugal type discharge elevator. So why we use the word centrifugal? You can look in this image, the material is, when centrifugal means away from the, when the material moves it tends to away from this. And in similar way, you can look when the buckets are coming from downside to upside, and when they are moving in circular motion, the materials get away from the center. So this center material gets away that tendency. Then next is positive discharge elevator. So this is the case of positive discharge elevator. So to make the positive discharge elevator, there is some changes in design. You can look, these buckets are forcefully move inside rather than moving like this motion. The buckets are moving like this. So what happened due to this, the material is drop here. So here positive type of discharge happened due to gravity. So as the gravity, to make the gravity material to fall, some changes is made as it's a regular part, but its part is changed like this so that the gravity will act and positive drop will happen here. The next is continuous discharge bucket elevator. So you can look in this image. So here the buckets are very closely mounted and they are continuously giving the discharge here. So that's why it's called continuous discharge bucket elevator. And to make this happen, a series of buckets are closely placed so that they are continuously dropping the material. The next is cement mill bucket elevator. So this is the cement mill bucket elevator. So this type of bucket elevators are used in cement industry. So there is some design changes. Then next one is the super capacity bucket elevator. So super capacity bucket elevator is shown here. So it have a super capacity or large capacity. Now centrifugal discharge elevator. So this type of discharge depends upon the centrifugal force. So what is centrifugal force? When something revolves in circular motion, then it have tendency to go away from the center. And in similar way, in this elevator, when these buckets are coming here, so they are tasked to moving like a circular motion. And due to circular motion, when they come at this point, the whatever the material inside this bucket tries to go away from their center. So that means they are discharged by the centrifugal force. So they go away from the bucket and they discharges at this discharge point. So centrifugal discharge bucket elevators have buckets mounted at intervals on a chain or a belt. So you can look, these are the buckets that are mounted on this belt. Or this type is used to handle bulk material like grain, which can be picked up by buckets and then discharged by centrifugal force over the head or head pulley. So these are discharged by centrifugal force. So important thing is discharged by centrifugal force. The elevator buckets discharge the product freely by the use of centrifugal force. So this is centrifugal discharge elevator. Now next is positive discharge elevator. So how positive discharge elevator works? So basically these are designed to elevate commodities such as popcorn, candy and potato chips, where the almost concern is on gentle handling of the finished food grade application. So as we look, popcorn, potato chips, they need to be handled very gently, and it operates on, so this elevator operates on double strand strain, where it holds a place by two pins, so the bucket is allowed to freely shovel. So you can look in this image. So when this bucket elevator rotates and when this comes at this point, thereafter this bucket is getting the discharge at this point very gently. And to happen this, you can look here. So this bucket elevator is made to move inside something in design, and so that it make a positive discharge. Then next is continuous discharge bucket elevator. So in continuous discharge bucket elevators have mounted continuously on chain. So these are mounted continuously on this chain. The material is directed into buckets through a loading leg. So material is directed into this bucket through this loading leg and is discharged over the face of preceding bucket while the passing around the head pulley. And when it is moving at this head pulley, this is discharge at this point. Also in this figure you can look, when this is the head pulley and these buckets are moving, they get discharge at around the head pulley while passing around the head pulley. So these elevators may be used to handle the same kind of material as centrifugal type, but they are recommended especially for handling the materials that are difficult to pick up. So this is the one of the design of the continuous type discharge. So you can look, continuously the material is fed into the buckets and then it is a continuously discharging. So one by one, after one bucket is emptied, another bucket is coming. So here is a continuous discharge is happening. Now fourth type is cement mill bucket elevator. So these are furnished bucket mounted on single strand of chain. So there is a single strand of chain. When the buckets are closely paced, material is directed to the buckets through loading leg. So this is the loading leg. And if buckets are more widely paced, loading is accompanied through or picking up direct loading through a loading leg. So loading leg. Material is discharged by centrifugal force over the head. So material is discharged above the point by using the same principle, that is a centrifugal force. Then next type is super capacity bucket elevator. So these are continuous type elevator in which buckets are mounted between two strands of chain. So in this there are two strands of chain. The design permits the bucket to extend the back of the chain center line, resulting in greater capacities. So what is the thing? The design permits these buckets to be at the center line of the chain so that it can have a greater capacity to hold the material. So that is why it is material. Now what are the advantages of bucket elevator? Number one, use in number of industries. So bucket elevators have application in number of industries including agricultural, food processing, cement industry and number of industries. So it is used in number of industries. Then second advantage, a large conveying capacity. Then number four, smooth transportation of goods. So while conveying the material, the transportation process is smooth, so there is no damage to the material. Then number 5, less maintenance. So it require less maintenance. When it is installed, it can work without maintenance for number of years. Then number 6, number 7, the long service life. So once installed, it can give a service for longer period of time. Then number 8, low driving power, wider range of lifting. So we can lift material in wider range of options available. So these are the some or few limitations. Then important question for practice. Question number 1, explain the construction and working principle of bucket elevator. So you have to draw the figure and you have to write the bucket elevator principle. So it operates on belt or chain, it have the buckets. So you have to mention or you have to explain. Question number 2, write the advantages and limitation of bucket elevator. So as we have seen the advantages, so there are number of advantages. It have less maintenance, higher capacities, reliable. Then limitations, so it require sometimes jams can be happen in bucket elevator. Then question number 3, give classification of bucket elevator. So as we have seen earlier, so you have 5 types. So you have to classify this centrifugal discharge elevator, positive discharge elevator, continuous discharge elevator, cement mill bucket elevator, and super capacity bucket elevator. So this is the end of the video. Thank you very much for watching this. Please like, share and subscribe.